Okay, so how will you work this out? You will need to know the frequency of A, B, C, and D. But you already know that. You will also need to know how many bits each of those symbols require. Now we also know that. So we will calculate the expected number of bits to transmit each symbol and then add them up. So for any symbol, the expected number of bits is given by the probability of seeing that symbol into the size required to transmit that symbol. And we add them up for all the symbols in the language. This is going to give us 1.75 bits on an average. Now, since we had to ask less questions in this language than the previous language, this language has less information. This is also called as variable length encoding. This should give you some idea into figuring out why some symbols in Morse code are smaller than others. In the English alphabet, the letters E and T occur most frequently. That's why in the Morse code, E is generated by a dot and T is generated by a dash. Since E and T occur more frequently, they have the smallest message size. This measure, which calculates the number of bits per symbol, is also called as entropy, and it is mathematically given as this formula. To make it more legible, we need to find out how to denote the size of S more properly. The size of S is also given by the log of 1 upon the probability of that symbol. So the formula of entropy is given as this.